Hello viewers, welcome to Mchuma Reviews on NTV. Many thanks for joining us. And today I'm just looking at a really cool car, a 2013 version of the Audi Q5. So the Audi Q5 is a really great German masterpiece, and I want us to have a look and get to know exactly what is going on and how this car is, so that you can know more about it. Join me as we have a look.
So first of all, Audi Q5 falls under the category of a mid-size SUV, or okay, you can say a crossover, you know, depending on how you want to call it. And Q5 is a really special car for me because it's one of my favorite cars, actually. And you know, basically when Audi made this car, they had a great market because a lot of people, especially in the world, in fact the whole world, there's a lot of market for SUVs and mid-size SUVs, the crossovers. And a Q5 is a special car because, number one, this one is fitted with a 2000cc turbocharged engine. Okay. And you're just gonna look at that even as you continue to generally look and explore this car. And I'd love us even to start and look at the first thing that you notice when you enter the Q5. When you just look at the Q5 is the daytime riding LED. They are so good, and of course you get the fog lights. You've noticed, but Audi has really massive grills, as you can see this one here. It's massive, and it is really good. I love the way it is with the car plus the black. You know, the contrast is good. And right here, we have a small emblem, Quattro. So Quattro basically means the all-wheel drive version of this car, and Audi offers this car in the front wheel and also the Quattro, so either two-wheel or four-wheel. But again, you know, you never go wrong with the four-wheel drive, you know. So I love this Audi, and you know, just as I told you, it's a very special car to me, and I know most of you viewers who are watching are gonna love this. And I just want us to come close and just, you know, basically look at how this car is. The shape is good, perfect for aerodynamics, and right here we have 19-inch alloy wheels. 19-inch are massive, plus, you know, a bit of profile, not really fat, but it's good, you know, for this car. Of course, get perfect ground clearance. You know, you can cruise in anywhere you want to go in this country with this Audi Q5, and the fact that it's a four-wheel drive is gonna be good. And you get turn signals on the side mirror. So, you know, Audi has done a lot to make sure that this car is very premium. So it's a Porsche car, it's a premium car, and everything, even the build material, when you touch this, the door handles, you see, it's quite heavy, very premium, and soft touch materials around here. So I love this color white. White is good. And if maybe I was supposed to buy this car, I'd change the rims, you know, just to paint them to be black.
White.
You know, because, well, the chrome is good, but I mean, I love black. You know, black on white is like a panda. So in case maybe I buy this car, I'm gonna nickname it the Panda, because black and white, so okay, and all that. So. Yeah. Opening up the boot or the tailgate is actually easy. Just come here on your key fob, and there's just a button you just press and hold. And also, there's just a button that you just press, and again, it opens. So when you look inside, you get a massive, massive storage. And of course, these seats lie down flat, and then you get more room. So you just come and pull this lever, and the seats lie flat. Of course, because of the seat belt, ndio maana ijanguka yote. But again, you have you know, really good lights here, convenient lights. Of course, you get hooks. There's hooks right here. And when you lift up this first floor, you get a spare tire. You know, maybe when you get a flat tire and you really need to go somewhere, this is a good tire that will at least help you cruise through and help you finish your journey. And you see this metal plate here, just helps you not to, you know, rub on the car, and just ensure that even when you load in your luggage, you're gonna able to do it very easily.
You don't spoil the edge.
Yes. And as you can see, it's quite lower, therefore even shorter people can be able to access this. And closing up the tailgate is easy. You can use also your key fob, or just come right here, and there's a button that you just press, and the boot wheels on. Now let us look at the interior. So right here at the back seat of this car, as you can see, I'm 6'3 and I have enough legroom and headroom, and this is a brown leather interior. You know, when you buy an Audi car, of course you expect to have a leather interior, and you get a really good armrest, and the you just press here and you get two cup holders, and therefore maybe when you're traveling with a special someone, you can have your drinks and all that, and you know, just enjoy life as you cruise. And the headrest, you can also adjust the headrest. This is just a lever you pull, and you just lift it up and down. And also, I love these seats because you can always adjust, you can recline or go back. So the Audi Q5 really did an amazing job right here. So when you are seated at the back, you know, back left, you'll be very comfortable. And of course, as you can see, the mirrors are quite low, and therefore you can have a very clear and good view. And I just want us to have a look. We have air vents, And you know, it's a dual zone, therefore the front passengers can see the climate, and the people at the back can also receive through these air vents. And right about here we have a 12 power volt socket, therefore the people at the back can always charge in their phones, or even maybe you're traveling with children, can just charge in their laptops or their PCs or their gaming electronic devices as you guys continue cruising on the road. Let's look at the front seats. We have a sliding armrest, so depending on your, you know, height and all that and your preference state, so you can always, you know, just rest your arm as you drive. And inside here you get a good storage, and there's a 12 volt power outlet inside there. And when you close it up, you get two good cup holders. And as you can see, this is wood trim that is actually, you know, in sync with the brown leather interior that you have here. And of course get this really wonderful chrome. And on this shelf, just slide it and you get also a 12 volt power outlet and a ashtray right there for while those who, you know, like to get a good smoke and they drive, get an ashtray right there. And basically I can tell you the build quality inside this Audi is perfect. It's phenomenal. And this is a gear selector. It's actually this is an 8-speed automatic that is fitted in this car. Imagine, yeah. It's got a ZF8HP, therefore it's an 8-speed gearbox, and it also has the Tiptronic. The Tiptronic is basically you can always just shift with your gear right here, so it's an automatic gearbox with Tiptronic, so you can just come and shift. So you just put in and drive maybe on sport mode, then you just shift your gears depending on how you want to do it. And Audi has done a great job in basically the infotainment system that you get in this car. And I just want us to test, so I've connected to Bluetooth and I've just had one of my favorites, so we're just going to test it just for a bit because of the copyright music. The car, and I just want us to look at a few things right here. As you can see, this is called hill descent assist. So maybe when you're cruising on steepy hills and you just want to, you know, have that really smooth transition, just press on this and then the car will actually cruise on itself. So you just hold on and control the steering wheel. This one is for traction control. This one is for parking sensors. This one is called auto hold. And this is just for selecting the driver's select, you know, just for choosing how you want to drive, the different drive modes, the dynamic, efficiency, comfort and all that. So auto hold helps you especially when you're driving, you know, maybe in traffic. So when the car comes to a complete stop, so you press on the brakes and then you press on auto hold. So the car will reduce power from the engine. It will not completely shut off the engine, therefore it will help you save a lot on fuel. And therefore when you release your brakes, the car will start up again. So it just helps you to save on your fuel and of course get the air conditioner and all that. So this is the infotainment system that you get in this car. This is the electronic parking brakes that you have engaged. So you just come here and you press menu, as you can see on our screen. You know, you just choose using this swivel wheel between navigation, radio, media, info car and all that. So basically it's a simple one to use. The BMW has the best, I not lie, I love the BMW one, is phenomenal. Yeah. You know, the BMW iDrive is just top notch, and then of course the Audi comes next, and the Mercedes kokonyuma. But again, you know, for the advanced version, the Mercedes MBUX is just ahead of its game. Now that's for the 2020 and you know the recent versions, but for this model the BMW is the best, and then followed keenly by the Audi. So want us to look at the steering wheel. As you can see, it's fully leather and you get paddle shifters right here. So when you're cruising and you just want, you know, to shift your gears, you could just do it through here. And you just have the mode where you just choose between audio and all that and all that. You can see from our screen right now, the last song we were playing was for Drake, the In My Feelings. Okay. Playing In My Feelings by Drake. And the Audi, you know, you can always adjust the steering depending on your height. So there's a lever that you just pull here, and then you just either telescopic or see, you know, in most cars you can just adjust in this manner, but now in the Audi you can, you know, push it forward or push it back depending on how you like to drive, maybe your perfect driving position. But personally I love it up here when I can exactly see the speedometer, and then I like it to push it a bit in front that, you know, can just rest my hand here on the armrest and, you know, just cruise and just listen to some fine music and the wonderful AC and all that and all that. So It's a really good car. And the front passengers of the Audi Q5 get memory seats. Therefore, three memory settings actually, as you can see here. Oh, two memory settings. Therefore, two people can drive this car. As you can see, this is my driving position. And maybe I can just press and then set one. And then maybe when my wife or my spouse or anyone wants to use this car, maybe it's a family car that the two of you use, you just come and press two. And it will adjust your seat and steering wheel to your preferred position. So there are some versions of this car that you get what we call a panoramic sunroof. This one, we do not have one, but we have a two-tone interior. So there's a version that you get a panoramic. So this car is offered in very many features. So depending on where you buy it and how you want it, you can always get it configured to you. Unlike in most cars, when you get the handbrake, so here you just come and just pull this lamp to disengage the parking brakes, and then there's a just button you just press and just shift it smoothly to drive, and you just start to go. So the first thing you notice when you're driving this Audi Q5 is that the steering wheel is very light, and therefore it's really easy to maneuver. You know, just maneuver slowly, and it's very comfortable in my hand, just the perfect size. You know, I'm so comfortable, and of course, you get the massive and great infotainment system. So, you know, just driving and, you know, just think about life and think about the COVID-19, and you just get some good music from Drake.
I like that, man. I do.
And, you know, just maybe you're just thinking about your shamba or your farm or anything. And so when you're in this car, you're so comfortable, stress-free, and you get very minimum wind and road noise. Yeah. As you can see, you're just cruising normally, and there's minimum wind and road noise. And the 2000cc turbocharged, bro, I tell you, this car, when you want to pull,
that's good, man. Let's pull it.
So it's a phenomenal car, I won't lie. It's a really great car. And that's why I told you it's one of my favorite, because the Audi just did a perfect job in driving, in you know, basically designing this car. And I don't know whether you've realized, but there's this theme of red. There's so much red, especially like you can see right here on the infotainment system.
Yeah.
There's so much red right here to you know, to on the light. There's so much red, and also on the door handles, just as you can see, it's red. There's some red, you know, lighting. All right, so because we do not have insurance, and I really do not recommend that you drive a car on the road without insurance. So we're not going to have this car on the road, but I'm just going to show you a few features that you can do with this car. You know, just to demonstrate. And, you know, of course, if you want the full feature, you can come here at Imports by Cairo, and then they're going to give you a test drive and all that. And they're going to give you one with the insurance. And, you know, even if you want to buy, you can always visit them. So there are a few things that I want us to learn. You remember I told you about auto hold? You remember, so I want to show you how it works. So when you're cruising, you know, you're just driving on the highway, and then, oh man, traffic on Thika Road, man, you know, you just want to chill. So you just come to, you know, when the car comes to a complete stop, that's when the auto hold engages. So tell me, what do you feel?
I like the car just stopped.
Exactly, it's like the engine has stopped completely, but it has not.
Oh.
Yeah, so it just helps you to save on fuel. So when you want to continue, you just lift your foot off the brake and the car will start again. So listen to this.
Ah, man. Magical.
Imagine. So basically that's how the auto hold works. And as you can see, the Germans have really done an amazing job in designing and just ensuring that you have a really smooth transition and a really smooth run when you drive these cars. And there's just one more thing that I want to show you, even as we finish up on this video, is what you call the hill descent assist. So hill descent assist helps the car to just cruise on its own, especially when you're descending on some steep slopes. So maybe when a place that you as a driver, you think that you might not be well, you know, maybe you really do not have the right skills to do that, so the car will just do it for you. So as we're exiting the mall, so just come right here, and yes, yeah. So there's this button that you just press to engage the hill descent, and then you just release your foot on the brake, and the car, as you see, the car is actually controlling the speed
itself.
Yeah, my leg is not on the foot brake, my leg is not on the pedal, the car is just getting downhill on itself.
It's kind of autopilot.
Yeah. Yeah, you can say that. So my role is just to control the steering wheel, but the car is just cruising on its own. So it helps you to...
So it just feels itself.
Yes, exactly. So just to disengage, just, you know, just press this, or just press just press this button to disengage, and then you're back. Then you just continue to cruise on your own. As you can see right here on the dash, soft touch materials, and we have wood trim here with some chrome, and you have the word quattro. As I told you earlier, quattro means the all-wheel drive of this car. And of course, on there's some storage space right, of course, out the insurance that you get in this car. So Audi did a great job in designing this Q5, and because, you know, it's my personal favorite. And you know, I told you earlier that it's a 2000cc and get the 8-speed gearbox. So when you're cruising in, there's some instances that you get about 5 liters per 100 kilometers, can you imagine, on the highway. And therefore, when you're traveling to like Migori County, I think it's about 300 or something. I guess maybe you're gonna spend like let's say 3000 in fuel. Imagine, you're gonna spend about 3000 in fuel. Yeah, so this is a really affordable car for you to maintain. So I love the fact the 8-speed gearbox is so good and helps you a lot in maintaining a really wonderful and steady fuel economy. And actually, a lot of people can actually maintain this car in terms of fuel. You're going to be good to go because you don't really spend a lot, and it's going to serve you very, very well. So thank you so much for joining us on this wonderful review or tour, Dickens. So as you're finishing up on this review, I just want you to tell us in the comment section, maybe what was your favorite thing that you loved about this Audi Q5. You're going to sample them and have a look. So thank you for joining us. See you some other time.
Wow, what's up?
We are done with the review here in Muchuma. So this is going to be out very soon. Could be today. No, tomorrow in the morning. Tomorrow, Saturday. It's been a great one, man. First time we were doing a review. But it was a success. Thank you. See you later.